So I've done this one before, but the original didn't make any sense. I'll keep it on as unlisted and it can be accessed from here, link in the description, but it should have been like a side notes thing. So this is that, a more coherent form of that entirely unqualified conjecture. Viruses, the things that can give you a cold or herpes, are basically just some DNA or RNA with a little something to protect them, and that's it. They don't really do anything, and most of them don't have any moving parts. They work by if they bump into a cell and the DNA enters, the components of the cell will produce proteins working from the viral DNA, and then those proteins will go on to form more DNA in capsules, more viruses. There's tons of diversity with viruses, and they infect different cells in different ways, and there can be proteins and other stuff in there too, but essentially, viruses are just some DNA with a little delivery mechanism. So if that's all they are they alive? What does it even mean to be alive? To be an organism. I mean, I have this idea that I am me, I am one thing, even though I'm a buttload of cells. And all organisms on the planet, us plants, fungi, bacteria, protists, are all cells. One cell or lots of cells together, except for viruses, which is why they're often considered to be not really alive. If you just removed the DNA from a cell, it wouldn't be considered alive, right? But then again, none of the individual components of the cell would really be considered alive. They can be in a shape that is unique and assembled by living systems, but enzymes, cell membranes, ribosomes, nutrients, water, none of that stuff in there is alive. Life might not be a bunch of objects that you can hold like that. Maybe it's what they do together that makes life life. But if we look at the way each component interacts, we wouldn't see any phenomena that you wouldn't be able to explain studying physics or chemistry. What I mean is everything going on happens predictably and just follows the fundamental physical properties of the atoms, like attraction and repulsion and different ways of bonding. But the interesting thing taking place is, well, it's kind of like a Rube Goldberg machine. Each aspect is inanimate, but each product of one interaction goes off and interacts with another, and another, and etc., in such a way that the system looks animated. But this machine isn't alive. Where is the life happening? A Rube Goldberg machine behaves with potential energy, one bit setting off another bit, and when it's done, until someone puts that energy back into it by resetting the bits. In a cell, the machine is branching and elaborate in ways I couldn't even begin to break down, here represented by these lines with arrows. But some of the components are able to get energy from light or chemicals and gather other molecules as nutrients, and in that way they supply themselves with the tools to reset or remake the pieces, and it continues the motion on its own. Also, another thing the cell machine can do is assemble other machines that are structured very similar to the original. This is what allows us not to just see the machine, but to continue to see the machine. Organisms breaking down or getting eaten is pretty inevitable. If organisms didn't assemble copies, then all life would eventually end. Those seem to be the differences. It's like a multi-branched, reproducing Rube Goldberg machine that doesn't stop. Where do viruses fit in? Viruses can kind of show us how central DNA is to the whole process. DNA isn't just another domino or cog in one stretch of the machine. It stores the information for the structure of all the proteins in the cell. And since proteins basically do or control or build everything in the cell, DNA controls what each component looks like, so it sort of designs the whole machine and the processes it does. Different DNA means different components and different processes. That's why you can have a different set of instructions come in and code for different proteins that do different things. In this case, just make more DNA in capsules. Could you have DNA come in and instruct the cell to do something else? Like, let's say a virus came in and instructed the cell to make a bunch of enzymes or something. That's fine, I guess. That could theoretically exist. But then after, you would never see that virus again. Just like with all DNA, viral DNA has to code for something that helps that DNA reproduce, or you won't see it anymore. It just so happens that there's plenty of cells around for this viral DNA to interact with without ever needing to code for or keep its own cell. And it works well as a strategy that DNA can take. Viruses are one of, if not the most numerous organism on the planet. If they are an organism, are viruses alive? Maybe a virus is an object that isn't alive any more than any other cell component, but a virus inside a cell is performing life just like any other cell component. Are they an individual? I guess that depends. Is the code the individual, such that any set of DNA traveling and reproducing together is one organism? Or is the code with the cell the individual, since the cell is the smallest unit that performs life? Is it about how things are attached, and that's why we can consider ourselves to be one organism? Same with those trees that can be an entire forest large and thousands of years old, since they've all stemmed from the same cloning root system. I think how things are attached is the generally accepted definition of the organism, but then where do viruses fit in? Is this one organism and this another organism? How about now, is this an entirely new organism, or is this more analogous to a parasite infecting a host? Or is this just some special case, since viruses aren't alive at all, so we don't even call them an organism? Maybe trying to point out which of these sets of objects is alive as an individual life form distracts from the processes that demonstrates what life is? Maybe life is just the cycling interactions and it doesn't matter matter how it's attached. Viruses have a discrete set of DNA with genes that reproduce on their own incentives, so it's convenient just to call them an organism. Anyways, I don't know. I'm just talking out of me butt. Let me know what your butts have to say in the comments. Evolving. Keep in mind, it's not the DNA itself changing. It's just the information, the order of the nucleotides that's being copied and changed. New DNA is assembled with each new cell, and the old DNA eventually falls apart. The thing that passes from one individual to the next is the information, the order of the nucleotides. Over time, the incidental and random changes in the sequence, and whatever works long enough to reproduce again, results in all the different